Guys, this lesson is really long, so I divided it into several lessons and made time codes in the description below the video. Enjoy the lesson! Hi guys, glad to see you! How are you doing? My cat is saying hi to you too. Today we're gonna talk about something that I use on my... Today we're gonna talk about something that you see in my every video. What is it? What do you think? Well, every time I have my glasses. In Russian, they are called очки. Очки. It's a short word, it's not that difficult for pronunciation. Just don't forget that unstressed O represents A sound. So that's why we write очки, but we pronounce it like очки. Guys, by the way, you know, my glasses are really old. I bought them, I think, in 2011. So I'm gonna change them. I need to go to an eye doctor and I need to ask him about new glasses. So guys, I'm starting saving money for a doctor visit first, and then I will save money for my new glasses. I got some donations after I bought my new program for editing videos. I got 300 rubles and 400 rubles. So now I have 700 rubles for a doctor visit. But actually I need 2,500 rubles. So if someone can help me, you're welcome to do that. A link for help is in the description below the video. The sooner I save a necessary sum, the sooner I will go to a doctor. Why do people have glasses? Why do they wear glasses? У меня плохое зрение. У меня плохое зрение. У меня плохое зрение. Когда я была ребенком, окулист выписал мне очки. Когда я была ребенком, окулист выписал мне очки. Когда я была ребенком, окулист выписал мне очки. But guys, окулист is a colloquial word for an eye doctor, but an official word is офтальмолог. 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 So I can say офтальмолог выписал мне очки. Офтальмолог выписал мне очки. But this word is pretty hard for children. That's why we got used to say окулист. My cat can't stop meowing, so I think she wants to say hi to you all. Kitty, say привет. And please, go, Kitty, go. How often do people wear their glasses? Я ношу очки каждый день. Я ношу очки каждый день. Also, we can replace a verb носить to ходить в. In this context, it means the same. For example, я хожу в очках постоянно. Я хожу в очках постоянно. Someone wears his glasses just when he works on the computer. So he can say, я надеваю очки, когда работаю на компьютере. Я надеваю очки, когда работаю на компьютере. Я надеваю очки, когда работаю на компьютере. Someone wears his glasses when he reads or when he watches TV. So he can say, я надеваю очки, когда читаю или смотрю телевизор. Я надеваю очки, когда читаю или смотрю телевизор. Я надеваю очки, когда читаю или смотрю телевизор. На улице сегодня солнечно, поэтому я надела солнцезащитные очки. На улице сегодня солнечно, поэтому я надела солнцезащитные очки. На улице сегодня солнечно, поэтому я надела солнцезащитные очки. The next topic is sunglasses. In Russian, we can say differently about sunglasses. An official name is солнцезащитные очки. The first word is really long. Literally, it means sun-protecting, sun-protecting. Солнце means the sun, and защитные means protecting. Let's find a stressed vowel. Солнцезащитные. И is stressed, but since this word contains two words, we pronounce it with two stressed vowels. Солнцезащитные. О is stressed too. So we don't pronounce it like а. We pronounce it like о, like a normal о. Let's talk about the first part of this complex word. There are two syllables. Сол. But look, there is a combination of three consonants. Л, Н, Ц. In this combination, we don't pronounce Л sound. We pronounce just Н and Ц. But we don't pronounce Н that clear. We make it a stop. Н, Н. So we don't make our tongue like Н, Н, Н. It's N. Сон, солнце. Yeah, is unstressed here, and this vowel is like a bridge for two short words inside a long one. So this letter represents U sound here. We don't pronounce it like E. If we say this word separately, солнце, then yes, we pronounce it like э sound. But in this long word, we pronounce it like ы. It's easier. Солнце за a closed а sound, not an opened one. Not are, not za, no. За, she. Then we see two consonants combination. Т, Н. For the next syllable, тны. But again, we don't pronounce Т separately. We pronounce it like a stop Т sound. Н, Н, Ны. Защитны. Yeah. The last vowel represents two sounds, Y and E, because it follows another vowel. Listen to this word pronunciation again and watch my mouth. Солнце защитные. Солнце защитные. Солнцезащитные. Солнцезащитные очки. But this word is really hard even for Russian native speakers. So, even if this word is the most correct one, Russians replace it with other words which aren't that grammatically correct, but they're just colloquial words. So, you can use this phrase, солнцезащитные очки, for sunglasses, but also you can hear such phrases like темные очки, темные очки, or more colloquial, очки от солнца, очки от солнца, очки от солнца. Also, I know a phrase that isn't correct at all. It's very, very colloquial, and this phrase is солнечные очки. Солнечные очки. Please don't say this phrase. It's wrong. But when you hear it, just know that it's about sunglasses. So, which phrase you can use? You can use солнцезащитные очки. It's the most correct one. Or you can use more colloquial one, очки от солнца. Also, you can say just очки if you don't wear such kind of glasses. Try not to use темные очки and солнечные очки. But don't forget that when you hear such phrases, they're about sunglasses. Well, guys, this lesson was really long and I hope it was really useful for you. Now you know more words, more phrases, more expressions about glasses in Russian. And don't forget that if you need private classes with a professional teacher, you're welcome to let me know about that. Please like this video. Write your comment and see you next time. Bye-bye.